Hello friends, welcome to my channel Dear Life. My name is Pankaj Sharma and welcome to the series of the leadership lessons. If you have not gone through my previous video on leadership lessons, that faith can move mountains. Yeah, you heard it very right. A faith can move mountains. So this was the video I created, the first one. This is the second video in the series of leadership lessons. In this video, I'll be going to share with you few important things. That what are the few important things is really important to become a successful leader. So remember, a leader is known as a leader because of the team. Team means the people, those who are reporting to you, the people, those who are there with you in an organization or anywhere. So if you see that these are the people, when you see these people and when you would like to achieve some task, this task, these goals will give you certain understanding where you need to go, and that provides you a direction. Now remember the importance of a direction. So I believe that you might have seen that temple run where somebody was keep on running, but the guy do not know where is he really going. So where is the objective and the goal and the direction, but he is keep on going. So does this happens with you also in your team? So many people, those who set goal, and most of the time you will see, this was a survey done by Yale University, that only 2% people are there, those who are setting goals for themselves, for their team and for their future and career. So do you have your people there, those who are reporting to you, those who are there with you, are they running without setting any goal? So this is a job and the responsibility of a leader. So now I'll be sharing with you the step-by-step approach, what exactly you should do to become a successful leader whenever people are there with you, along with you, and you need to set a goal for the people and for yourself. So remember here, these bigger goal, the yearly goals, can be broken down into the task, and task can be further broken down into the actionable areas. Now what are these actionable areas are there? So before you go and discuss with your team, and this is the task given to us, this is the task which we need to achieve and accomplish, before that, remember here, as I always said, that people moves because of that emotions. That emotions keeps them in motion. So when it comes to emotion, people are driven by the emotions. That is why the most difficult, you know, the skill is the man management skill and the people management skill. So remember here, do you know what are the lows and the highs of your team members? Now when I say low and the highs of your team members, so do this before you go and do this goal setting exercise for an entire year with your team. What are the things are there they really proud of, and they always claim that these are my life achievements. These achievements can be, you know, smaller things. Somebody might have, you know, attempt and the competition in a school and achieve something in the any cricket or any game sports or any other curriculum activities, like speech, like the essay writing or the competition or anything, or maybe for that matter, say for an example, the dance competition, fancy dress competition. So these are the happy moments of these people. They cherish every time whenever they would like to recall their past memories. Sit with your people before you go and do this goal setting exercise. Ask them to share the moments of their life which really they cherish always, and these are the moments which gives them the sense of pride and the proud. So when they share, so believe you me, when people share about their past memories and their past achievements, they always used to share, and they really relive that moment of that success moment or the moment of the joy or the happiness. So you can see this on the face of the people whenever they are sharing. You will see they are smiling, there is an expression which are changing, and people are very fluently, very proudly, they share about those things, compliment them. So your each team member is a very important constituent in your entire team, that they make the team. So understand what are the highs of their people, your people, what are the highs of their life as of now. Maybe their previous organization's achievements, if somebody was, you know, the zonal topper or All India topper, or might have gone through the international trip from an organization. So this is number one. Number two, what are the lows are there? What are the dreams are there, what are the ambitions are there for which they are working. So for example, you can ask people, what would you like to achieve and why? So success lies in this why. When you ask to the people may share and they become emotional, right? I have seen during my training programs, when I share and when I ask people that share about, you know, the 3-4 reasons why are you working in an organization, what would you like to accomplish, right? So when they share about that why they would like to achieve, they become really emotional. They want, somebody wanted to share, I still remember one person shared that I wanted to build a home for my parents. Why? What was the reason? Because their home was, you know, so small that 5-6 member, they are unable to accommodate. Then that guy was sharing that I am not able to, my parents are not able to invite, you know, other guests because the space is not available there. So what are their small needs are there? What are their small, you know, ambitions are there? These all needs and ambitions will keep them aligned along with that particular goal. Now comes to number 3. Number 1, I shared about their, you know, the highs of their life, successes of their life, happy moments of their life. Number 2, their lows of their life, what they would like to accomplish, their, you know, objective ambitions. And number 3, as a leader, this is the responsibility of a leader to align their personal goal with the organizational goal. What does it mean? It means when people share about their personal objectives and their personal goal, their family goal, right, they would like to achieve, they would like to fulfill, right, aligning these, their personal goal, to the organizational goal. That is why if you achieve this at the end of the year, you will be going to fulfill your 1, 2, 3 personal goals. So this is called the exact goal setting process. When you exactly go for giving them the assignment or the stretch goal or the targets, talk to them, sit with them, do these 3 things. Number 1, understand their highs of their life, understand the lows of their life, and understand that how are you able to align their personal goal, their family goal, their financial goal, their academic goal with the organizational goal which are there. So if you are able to do this, I think you will be able to become successful as a leader, because people work for you. Because if after, you know, doing all these 3 steps, if you ask someone to push harder, to stretch from their comfort zone, remember, the person will going to thank you rather than cursing you. Why this happens, you know? Because they see their success into this alignment of their personal goal with an organizational goal. So this is the very important goal setting exercise which a leader must do whenever the leader is setting a goal for their team. I believe that you are understanding and learning about the exact goal setting process for your people. So next time, whenever you are sitting with your people, and remember here, when it comes to setting the goal, don't set the goal in the group. Right, so this is how, you know, the group is, dynamics are completely different as compared to an individual dynamics, and individual needs are an individual needs. If you are a leader and you know the individual needs and you know that how to fulfill an individual needs, that increase the kind of trust in between a leader and the colleagues. So this trust will definitely going to lead towards the good, you know, the relationship building, and this relationship building will be helpful in terms of fulfillment of those organizational goal and the personal goals. So thank you so much for watching. I believe that these lessons are useful to you. My request to all of you, please subscribe to the channel. Please share this with as many people possible. If you are working in an organization in the for the private, you know, enterprise, or if you are working as an entrepreneur also, if you are having team along with you, if you really want that your team members should align with you, do this, follow this. I am sure that you will be going to become successful. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.